Hi, my name is Lynn Taylor and my company's Taylor Made Plans, and today I'd like to show you a set of construction drawings for a brand new house or stock plans, which I sell on my website. Primarily these are inner city historic neighborhood house designs. They're craftsmen's, Victorians, and also very contemporary craftsmen and Victorians. So they're considered stock plans is what you call them. It's like a pre-done plan. You just go through and search your square footage that you're interested in, all the specs. And then you can buy a set of construction drawings for like $750, five sets, and then you can build that house one time, and then if you would like to build it more, you send a reuse fee in. So that's what a stock plan is. It's a pre-done plan. You can also then take that plan if you want to do modifications to it. You could hire me then to just modify and change a few things, and that would add on to the price of the stock plan fee. You could also just do a total custom plan where we take and just start from scratch completely, and then that would be more expensive, of course, and I would have to give you fees on that. But today we're going to look at a set of plans, and this is my cover sheet. Now on the cover sheet, I've just got some basic information. Climate zone information. These are designed in Nashville, Tennessee. The building code, which is based on 2006 International Residential Code. Some information here for the estimator and the lumber yard. These house plans, like I said, fit into historic neighborhoods, and they have a little historic feel to them. They're designed to fit in, and we're not using customized or replicating exact trim work, but they're materials that you would use off of a shelf at one of the lumber yards or a big box store like Lowe's or Home Depot. So, but they're not like what you would build out in the suburbs. So if a builder's used to just building houses in the suburbs, this might throw a little loop. He would just need to pay attention to the details more because it's a little different arrangement of materials to get that historic feel. Let's go to the next section. Primarily, I want to show you what you get in your construction drawings. Sometimes, you know, construction drawings are not created equal. You can have a great design, and then maybe the designer wasn't as had enough technical experience to really put together the house. Everybody has a different level of experience. So we put a lot of time and effort into our details so that when the builder gets out there, there's least amount of problems. You get a better estimate on your drawings and less guessing and head scratching is what I call it in the field. So most of the plans are set up the same way, same type of sheets, different if you have a two-story, one-story. This here is the first floor plan. You got your dimensions, your window sizes right here by the windows, of course your plumbing, any particular notes that would be required here, talking about especially like here beside a tub, you want to put an energy break there, which is you go ahead and insulate that, a half inch piece of foam or a quarter inch piece of foam behind the tub prior to setting the tub. That's an energy break and an energy efficient note that I have on the drawings. Let's see what else. Also dimension and note the porch columns and things like that, trim detail a little bit here. And then here's some general information here about Energy Star windows and what you would want to do if you want to get more energy efficient into your home. Okay, let's go to the next one. So that's the first floor plan, and then this is the electrical layout. I do not put the electrical and all the notes and dimensions on one plan. I separate them out. So you're here, you have your basic legend and just where your switches and lights, and this is based on standard recommendation kind of thing. Very straightforward. We have a big note here that says, subcontractors, if you make a hole, please seal it. This is to stop the air infiltration going from your crawl space into your house. If your subcontractors are not careful and do not caulk and seal up everything, then you're just going to have air moving back and forth. We recommend actually doing a sealed crawl space with some air conditioning in it. And this just helps with better air quality control, also not breathing the dirt from your crawl space. Again, these are notes on the drawings, and unless the contractor or you enforce it, they still may not do it just because the notes are on the drawings. Okay. The next sheet we usually have is interior trim details. I give different options here. We can go pure craftsman or traditional design. We can go more modern. We can have a very simple, inexpensive trim detail. So it's really, you can pick and choose which one of these you want. These are all custom trim, so they're made out of inexpensive wood, things you can pull off the shelf, or you can just go ahead and just buy what you can find in stock. So these are just going to give you a little bit of variation on your interior trim details. Sometimes I have interior elevations. Sometimes kitchen elevations come with like smaller houses because of community development, affordable housing organizations need them for certain reasons. This particular house has a fireplace with a built-in bookshelf, and so I have a little detail there. Also, houses with stairs on two stories, I will have a wall stair section cut just to show you the headroom. Also trying to give the framer some dimensions so that you'll be able to move a piece of furniture up those stairs when it's built.